So thank you very much for the invitation. And I try to feel the responsibility that I am the last lecturer today. I was very happy when I read the open call, because as David mentioned, I read the book about Ferenc Bán, and I think the majority of his works, and definitely this house, is absolutely connected to the conference topic, utopias and realities. And more exactly, I think the tension between utopias and realities. So I would like to show you through only one building. So I think it's a scale change compared to the other lectures, not an urban concept, not a city center, and so on, only one building. I would like to show you this, I think, very dramatic story of this building. So, people behind ideas, as the section title was named, and truly it's very important to see together the impact of the international mainstream, the local possibilities in the 70s in Hungary, and last but not least, the architect, who had extreme ambitions in every period of his life. Ferenc Bán was born in 1940, and after some years in a construction company, he came into view as a winner of the competition of a building when he was only 30 years old, which is the topic of my lecture, the County Cultural Center of Nyíregyháza. Almost all of his designs and buildings are inventive experiments, taking also the risk of errors embedded into an international tendencies as well. All of his plans were again and again trying to exceed the possibilities and expectations of the local authorities or the very strict demands of the construction background of industrial conditions in the socialist era. This point of view is always important, but especially in the 70s and 80s in Hungary, as I can see through all of his realized works. Maybe this tension between the ambitions and the possibilities caused a lot of unbuilt plans in his oeuvre, but caused some extremely powerful buildings as well, which with their controversiality became important masterpieces inside and outside the mainstream canon as well. Where is the place where our building is standing on? Nyíregyháza is the seventh largest town in Hungary, located in the eastern and poorer part. The individual expressive and artistic vision of Bán's architecture established an architect studio in East Hungary, far from the capital. In the context of the large and impersonal Nyírtev, one more institute for Peter, after Ipar Terv, Kösti, and so on. Yes. It seems obvious that the geographical conditions and opportunities for the construction industry created such a macroclimate of performing architecture which met individual architectural ambitions in a very special way. I have to mention the important issue of the cultural centers in Hungary in these decades. The political decisions of the controlled and centralized place of entertainment and cultural activities caused a huge number of the type of these buildings. You can see a beautiful still life of the city life in Nyíregyháza in the middle of 80s, yes, which maybe can symbolize this effort of the power with the new elements of the town and the policeman in the forefront. Bán's entry design broke with the formula of cultural centers typical of the period, which usually led to featureless typical solutions built from prefabricated structures, and came up with a concept based on a very special approach. But the way until it was realized were based on strong individual ambitions to fight against the uniform requirements. The County Cultural Center of Nyíregyháza is a faithful reflection of the more than a decade-long design construction period of the house. The competition was in 1969, the design period took to 1974, and the construction phase started after it and finished only in 1981. My presentation will be divided into three parts. First, I would like to draw the theoretical background of the cultural center of Nyíregyháza, show the impacts of the international trends of metabolism, and some reference buildings, not only from the country, which were the home of this architectural theory. Second, I will try to present shortly a story of the very long design and construction period with the changes of the concept of the structure, and then finally, we will arrive to the last period, which was finished 2 years ago. This strong metamorphosis closed the heroic life of the building and started something new. Clarifying my thesis, I will cite some buildings from all over the world, proving the universal meaning and the connections of Bán's building. This tension between the universal ambitions and the narrow possibilities of the grey weekdays of an East Hungarian town in the 70s is the main focus of my lecture. So in the first part of my lecture, I would like to reconstruct the theoretical background of the county cultural center of Nyíregyháza. The possible connections with architectural movements or concepts seem to be very clear and strong. It could be very useful to see not only the famous original examples from the roots of the theoretical concepts, but those projects which were realized or planned far from the fountains of ideas, especially in Middle Eastern Europe. Japanese architecture is blooming on the sand of Nyírség. Said with some sarcasm, György Csete, one of the most important architects from the organic group in Hungary, referring to the cultural center of Bán. Indeed, in connection with the first half of this oeuvre, the most commonly mentioned international influence is Japanese architecture, most specifically the architecture of metabolist utopias discussed in studies and evaluations written at the time or later on the early works of Bán. The concept of metabolism is basically a biochemical concept, meaning the material, energy and information flow occurring in living organisms. The concepts of architectural metabolism appeared in Japan in the 60s, both as theoretical as well as urbanist ideas. After World War II, Japanese architecture, understandably, also made efforts to position itself in the international forefront. Defining architects like Kikutake, Kurokawa, Fumihiko Maki, Kenzo Tange, Arata Ishizaki placed such concepts in the focus of architectural and urbanist thinking as growth, flexibility, or structures constructed from interchangeable design elements, enzymed forms and capsules. These concepts were based on the distinction between primary and secondary structure elements. The concept of metabolism was introduced by Fumihiko Maki, who says that a megastructure is a frame structure in which a significant part of urban functions is incorporated. The Japanese metabolist group tried to develop an independent architectural and urban planning system with a morphological approach. Their concepts proposed an urban architectural solution for the disturbing contradiction of the growing population and limited land available for new construction. Urban scale meant the smallest unit, which is the flat, the residential container, regarded as the basic element, could be attached to the infrastructure, appearing as an urban megastructure freely in time and space. This way, it ensured the continuous and flexible development and change of the city. The Tokyo Bay plan of Kenzo Tange or the spatial structure of Arata Ishizaki from 1960 for the vertical expansion of Tokyo outlined the high impact vision of the megastructure's urbanist concept. But there were also some completed buildings that for the reason of their scale could be regarded as models of these urban planning ideas, like Kurokawa's Nakagin Capsule Tower building completed in 1972, as the previous slide showed, or Kenzo Tange's Yamanashi Broadcasting and Press Center in Kofu from 1966. But what did the effects of metabolism mean far from this, its source region? I would like to show two examples and then the community house itself, of course. In 1975, the building of the Ministry of Highway Construction, it was visited by David and Attila, if my information is okay. So it was built in Tbilisi, which is a construction of masses standing on pillars, stretched between these legs like bridges. And it can be related to the movement rather for its form development learned from the metabolists than for the theoretical aspects. Much earlier, in 1966, Laszlo Kis, architect of Kösti, prepared a plan for the siting of Elte Stratford Garden in the heart of Budapest. His concept consisted in the construction of a flexible structure floating above the urban fabric, supported by the vertical cores that contained the circulation and service functions in the downtown of Budapest. And how did it influence Bán's architecture? Let me cite some sentences from an interview of him. As I started to work in the mid-60s, I naturally met Japanese metabolism. At that time, Japanese architecture was the top anyway, the standard. We couldn't stop admiring what and how they were constructing. For example, the Olympic swimming pool of Kenzo Tange was a peak performance. I too was influenced by it. And it's not by accident that the community house in Nyíregyháza was designed as it was. Imre Makovec, who was the founder of the organic movement in Hungary, which has a totally different approach of architecture, said about Bán's building. The enormous bridge torso cultural center in Nyíregyháza is the example of this architectural approach, metabolism, one word of Kurokawa's language. After much wrangling, being late for its own time, finally it was born as the classic piece of the architectural ideas of the 60s, being the only one in the country. The building to which Makovets compared Ban's cultural center was the Odokyo drive-in restaurant by Kurokawa in Japan, finished in 1969, where the mass of the restaurant space is suspended into a two-story high, three-dimensional truss structure. Despite the construction being protected for a decade, at the beginning of the design of a cultural center was embedded in current international developments, and for this it is perhaps enough to perceive that the Italian Renzo Piano and the British Richard Rogers won the commission for the Pompidou Center in the 1971 design competition, 2 years after the competition announced for the building in Nyíregyháza. The Pompidou Center, built in 1977 in Paris, is a project that places the supporting structure, circulation and services to the facade, and thinks in flexible interior space structures, not as a metabolist building, but as a metabolist did. Of course, Nyíregyháza is not Paris, and the Hungarian community house on the countryside is not the paradigm-changing museum concept of European metropolis. Within the quiet grey architectural world of the 70s in Hungary, Ban's building reflects the longing for faraway and the inventive experiment for heroically exceeding the given possibilities. Sorry. In the second part of my lecture, I would like to show the design and construction period of the building. The plan, unexpectedly winning the competition, was realized through a process full of struggles that were sometimes heroic. It was a nightmare, not a dream. It was extremely hard work, but I recalled the long years of construction. The architectural manifestation of the desire to break out and be different was too far fresh from the reconstruction industrial, architectural, and cultural reality of the time, making the realization process difficult. In addition, the young architect's ambition manifested in an extreme structure indeed, not only because he imagined this large-scale building exclusively from monolithic concrete structures, but because these structures themselves, due to the monumental span and cantilever design, meant huge challenge for the contractors. Although the construction was sometimes halted and went through a number of redesigns, but the idea of permanently stopping the work never came up. The idealistic vision of the first version remind us the most of the perception of Japanese metabolism that was thinking in fixed large structures and modifiable, flexible spaces. Accordingly, the competition design contained trusses running longitudinally on both sides, supported by monumental monolithic building structures similar to the bridge pylons, and trusses with Firandel system placed crosswise. Firandel system means that the trusses do not block the free and flexible use of space and have no traverse elements. The drawing presenting this version expresses the architect's double ambition and desire for freedom the best, the relationship to current international trends, and the intention to break out from the constraints of the Hungarian construction industry. During the planning, even during the construction that started in parallel, the limitations of the structure's technical feasibility came to light. Loads resulting from the large span led to the unavoidable impossibility of this structural concept. The filigree structures became thicker and thicker, but the amount of reinforcement, the steel in the concrete, calculated for columns and beams, encountered feasibility problems. Hardly any space was left for the concrete between the steel elements. Ban decided to change the previous structural concept by the time. Instead of the Firandel trusses, I try to draw it with these red lines, these Firandel-like trusses, running crosswise, which was theoretically the clearest version. They designed two longitudinal box-like support structures added to the longitudinal trusses on both sides, and these boxes contain the entrance, first floor, level corridors. So this red line shows the final version of the statical model. While the conceptual purity and spatial flexibility was reduced. Since this way, a five-tracked upstairs level was created where two pairs of cantilevers carried the load of the house, meaning that the loads on the spectacular facade trusses were specifically reduced. Finally, the plan became realizable. These inevitable processes gradually altered the intellectual context of the building too. It presented a less clearly theoretical building, which reflected the background of metabolism theory studied by Ban, but much more a house built as a Hungarian interpretation and illustration of Japanese buildings in which the original ideology is manifested. In this section, you can see the lifting mass from the ground, the two huge staircases which lead to the main entrance hall in the first floor, and above it, the two more levels which are situated inside the two-story high structures. The main entrance was under the structure in the two-story high glass blocks. The lobby, smaller rooms and offices were placed on the five-track middle level as a variable secondary layer. The corridors perfectly draws the box beam structures. On the top level, referring to Kenzo Tange's structure for the 1964 Tokyo Olympic Games, there would have been a floor under a pressed roofing structure, giving place to an auditorium and its community lobby that could be opened together. But instead of being flexible, they were built as two large fixed rooms. And finally, a few words about the renovations. Despite the original metabolism-rooted flexibility of the building, it underwent significant and adverse conversions during the decades of use. Areas under the building never became truly living urban spaces, as Bán imagined originally. While the changes in the building's environment and the development of other city areas affected the use of spaces around the county cultural center as well. The glass cube providing transparency under the bridge structure was soon covered and transformed. Over more than 30 years, the physical deterioration of the building also took place. Its mechanical system certainly became outdated, and although the quality and aesthetics of the reinforced concrete structures didn't change, the sustainability of the building proved to be questionable. The building was definitely rejected by a society. It never became an accepted building by the citizens. We can also talk about functional obsolescences, since the spatial program of the original cultural and methodological center voided. These processes intensified the sounds that urged the demolition of the house, both at public and political level. But the intellectual environment also changed, as the ideology of metabolism, no matter how influential it was internationally, and its realized architectural examples today are more like the documents of the time, and the architectural intellectual relevance of the building in Nyíregyháza has also been re-evaluated. The surreal structure, which once emerged from the surrounding one-story urban fabric, is located in a different urban position today, surrounded by houses of the same or larger height. By the mid-2000s, the former megastructure piece of work was already interpreted much more as a vast public plaza object being the witness of the former heroic architectural structural gesture. Instead of the ideas of metabolism, today the building conveys in a dramatized and pathetic way the contemporary elementary face in the operability of architectural theories. But the demolition of the stairs, Bán placed the entrance to the glass volume built under the building on the ground floor. This ground floor space utilization, as well as the topographic intervention underneath the building and filling the ground level to different extent, promised the possibility of using the semi-open space as an operable urban space. However, the concept radically transformed the roof level and the therefore necessary circulation system. During the renovation completed in 2014, designed by him, the two halls on the top floor were demolished and replaced by a multifunctional theater hall. The undeniable advantage of this solution is that by sliding the lower part of the auditorium, the open space concept of the former design can be achieved. However, its undoubted disadvantage is that the middle section of the roof, imitating a pedestal structure composed between the two pylons, had to be demolished because of the space requirement of the new large hall with the gallery. This fundamentally changed the original roof form suspended between the two pylons. In addition, the meanwhile changed regulation justified the placement of escape staircases and an elevator, and these were added to the large structure as independent towers, abstract and sculptural forms. This way, the longitudinal facade along the boulevard was completed with two open steel structure outdoor escape staircases, while a solid elevator tower and a partly glazed smoke-proof enclosure were placed to the main entrance side. These four towers are connected to the building by closed and open bridges. The building has undergone a strange metamorphosis. During the 2014 construction walking with Ferenc around the expanded structure, one could really feel the uncompromising spatial manifestation of the original architectural ambition. Over time, however, not only the functional requirements or the intellectual, physical, and urban environment changed, but also the architectural approach of Bán. After the buildings, made of monolithic and prefabricated large structures, in the second half of the 80s, his attention turned to the potential of postmodern form language, while since the mid-90s, he has searched for the potentials inherent in the plastic, sculptural forms, or resulting from the relation to each other. The renewal of the cultural center of Nyíregyháza bears the principles and traces of this last creative period that is in a strong contrast with his architectural conceptions 30 years earlier. The tension was hardly avoidable. The functional demands were almost impossible to meet within the framework of the structure. The current architectural gestures are able to exist next to the former megastructure piece of work. Being attached to it now was imprints of Bán's architectural behavior, thinking in sculptural, poetic forms, in an additive way, grown together with the huge building object of the young Bán creating intuitive structures. So finally, I aim to present the long construction history of the County Cultural Center of Nyíregyháza, which being one of the most important works in Hungary reflecting Japanese metabolism in some respect. This building is the most unique house of Bán, decisive also for later works. And this building is a witness of a period of the Cold War, which was great from a long distance point of view, but which has some important and original experiments, especially between the period of socialist realism and postmodern. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Levente. So after the myth of Danish architecture in Hungary, we saw a myth, the metabolism architecture in Hungary, in Nyíregyháza. So yeah, we have questions, thank you.
So during the 60s or 70s, did Bán have the possibility to travel to Japan to have a look at originally these buildings, this metabolism?
No, the story was that after the university, he wasn't so good student at the university. He often mentioned it as head of the diploma jury after finishing this process. So he went to a construction company, the company who build coal mining buildings, so not designed, build coal mining buildings, and it's very boring for him. And he mentioned that he borrowed Japanese magazines from the library. I don't know why a construction company ordered Japanese magazines in the 60s. It's very funny, but he drew and copy all of these emblematic Japanese buildings, and this was the way, a kind of autodidactic way to learn and have the influence of Japanese architecture.
Thank you for this presentation. Firstly, I'm not sure whether I understand it right, but I think you said that the construction of this building is a result of a competition, right?
This reconstruction?
Yeah, like the.
No. The designer was same. That he was the designer of the this reconstruction, the last phases of the building. This was the question. Oh, the original.
Yeah.
It was a competition. Yes.
Yeah. Therefore, I'm wondering what does other competitors, offering looks like, and how come the developer or whoever made the decision have such a big, I don't know, preference to such a extraordinary offer.
So I have no exactly information about it, but I think there was an architect named Antal Pless, who was a famous teacher and famous architect in the eastern part of Hungary, and he was the mentor of Bán, of the young Bán, and he was in the jury, and I think he can convince the other members who are absolutely, I think, didn't understand anything of these drawings, and maybe this was the first step to build this building.
And what was the contemporary reaction when he won this competition? So the colleagues or in the
end of 60s?
In end of 60s, yeah. So not because you mentioned some reactions later, but exactly when he won.
I read and heard some stories that maybe I can find this picture from the beginning of my presentation. When the long construction is started. Where is this very good picture? Yes, this is. Yes. So in this period of the building process, an architect group from Budapest, exactly the master of the master school, masters of the master schools from Budapest, visited the site, and I think they were very polite, but I can read some comments that they can't understand this building. But I think this building and his later so the other buildings of him because of the others buildings he reached a very very good position in the during the architect community. I don't know how to say. So I think understand and didn't understand this. Understood and didn't understand. This was the feeling. This was the how can I express better. So it was a success in very there were two parts of the architects for a very big group. He was an idol. His works are very very important. However, his works are more or less understandable or heroic or extreme. The other parts of the architects are it's very funny guy in the eastern part of Hungary. Okay. So this was this, and I think this double reaction of his oeuvre is always with his house by house was true.
Just to finish the story. So what happened in the recent years when somebody had to decide and somebody had to be persuaded about the values of the building to keep it, not to demolish? Because you mentioned that there were plans for demolishing, and how could we keep the building? So what was the story behind?
I think, but maybe it's only an interpretation, because of the financial cost of demolition was very, very, very hard. I think this was the first reason, as Ferenc mentioned when we talked about it. And second, there was a story which is, I think, a very important story, but not in this conference, is the system of the European protected building process I think not in Hungary, that there are a lot of requirements which determine the construction way or the building way. For example, I'm sure that these stairs and this very huge hole in the top of the building, which caused this new form of the building, is absolutely because of these requirements, which is absolutely strict, and there's no way to change it.
I just wanted to mention that this book of Levente about the work of Ferenc Bán, you can check it out actually on the ground floor in the reading corner. It's bilingual, English and Hungarian. It's a great book. And also there is another book about Yugoslavian architecture. It's called Modernism in Between, which might answer some of your questions regarding to this specific situation of Yugoslavian modernist architecture. That's also a great reading.
Just a small comment to your question about how other architects reacted to Bán works. As I know, most of them refused. Even in TV shows, there was a series in Hungary led by Judit Oshko. It was a propaganda series about architecture about modernist architecture, and there was. One show with other well-known Hungarian architects who are older and better than Ferenc Bán, as Reimholz and Ferenc István. It's familiar only for the Hungarians, but it's important. He clearly refused these buildings and also the other ones. I think younger architects started to appreciate his architecture.
Okay, bye. I think it can be said that there is Hungary, there was, and there is a master school of the Association of the Hungarian Architects. And Bán was, if I know it well, outside of this master school. Yeah? Egy nem volt mesteriskolás, nem?
No, student, I think the first cycle of master school, the second, and he was master of this master school. So I want to explain, but not so successfully, that it was a controversial process to judge him and to clarify his work by the colleagues as well.